Hi PreK families, Miss Tran here. Welcome to another week of How To From Home. So this week is episode number 6, and we're gonna learn how to build a marshmallow structure. So this week in PreK, we're exploring STEM activities, and STEM stands for science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. So STEM activities are great for fostering ingenuity and creativity. These types of activities can also lead to new ideas and innovations. So let's get to it. So first thing that we need in this How Tuesday is we're gonna need a bag of mini marshmallows or whatever marshmallows you have at home. And you're going to need toothpicks. So we're gonna start with a couple of 2D shapes, and then we're gonna move into some 3D shapes. So the first thing that we're gonna do is just pour out some of our toothpicks and pour out some of our marshmallows. And this activity is fun because you might use a lot if you're building your structure large, or you might not use very many at all. So it depends on how big of a structure that you want to make at home. Okay. So the first thing that we're gonna start with is we're gonna learn a 2D shape and how to make a square. So we're gonna stick it in there and two pieces of marshmallow on each end of one toothpick. Awesome. You're gonna do that again and you're gonna create another, another two. So now you should have two that look like this. So you'll have four marshmallows and two toothpicks. Now you're gonna take two more toothpicks and you're gonna stick them in to the marshmallows on both like that. Perfect. And do it again on the other side. So now you're going to have four marshmallows and four toothpicks. These activities are really great at home because they also help our little learner at home how to count. So you can count, challenge them and on how many marshmallows that they need or how many toothpicks that they need. So we have now made a 2D shape of a square. Okay, we're gonna make another 2D shape of a triangle. So we're going to take one toothpick, one marshmallow, take another one. So we made it just like that before. Now we're gonna take the toothpick and put it into the top there. And another marshmallow and another toothpick. So all together, when we create a triangle, we have three toothpicks and three marshmallows. So these are some simple 2D shapes that you guys can create at home. So we have a square and we have a triangle. But you can also make 3D objects out of these 2D objects. So what you need to do is you're gonna have to build more squares. So let's focus on the square right now. We're gonna turn this square into 3D object called a cube, and a cube is like a little box. So this will be the bottom of our box. So we're gonna need to make exactly the same structure again. So four marshmallows, four toothpicks. We'll make it here. Perfect. There we go. And we have our second square. Okay, so now if you envision it, it's gonna kinda go like this on top of there so that we can make a cube. So you're going to need to grab four more toothpicks and you're gonna point them down. Oops, one of my toothpicks is running away. And I'll point down, point this one down, and point this one down. So you should get something that looks kind of like a little a square tent or thing that'll cover. So it'll look like that. And then you're gonna take it and flip it. We'll put it this way. And you're gonna add the top to it. Perfect. So there, now we have our 3D shape, which is a cube. You can make several cubes and then you can make your structure even taller. You can stack your structure however big you want to make it. But this is the base. You can start with one cube if you like. Okay, now we're gonna put our cube over to the side here. and it'll just be in the screen so you guys can see. And we're gonna make another 3D shape. So we have a triangle right here. And what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna make a pyramid. And one thing that's kind of tricky about pyramids is they actually have a square base. So what we're gonna have to do is make another square. So to make a square again, we need 4 marshmallows and 4 toothpicks. We'll get that going. And that's just gonna be the base, and that the base is just the bottom of the triangle so that it doesn't fall over, so that the pyramid doesn't fall over. Perfect. Okay, so you're gonna see this square here, and the triangle will be right here. So we can actually remove the bottom ones from this one here. And we're going to stick them in to that one. So there's one side of our triangle. Now we're gonna need another toothpick. And we're gonna make kind of a V, an upside down letter V. And we can put it on this side, and these ones will kind of stick together too. You can just push the toothpicks through the top of those like that. And there is our pyramid. So on the bottom is a square. I don't know if you guys can see that square around there. And then what you do is 2 triangles at the top. So 1 triangle there and 1 triangle over there. And it ends up making 4 triangles by putting it together. So that turns this, that simple triangle, 2D shape, into a 3D shape, which is called a pyramid. Perfect. So now we have 2 different shapes, and you can use more toothpicks if you want to build it. You could build a house if you wanted. You can build different things with those marshmallows and toothpicks, so that's up to you. So one of the things I'm going to challenge you guys is I want to see if you know how to make a circle at home. So a circle is going to be a little bit harder because it doesn't have those straight edges, but I want to see if you know how to make a circle at home, and if you're really creative, even trying to make a sphere, which is like a ball. Okay, so I'm going to leave these my 3D objects back here, and we're just gonna get into a little bit more. So that's my challenge for the week, try to make a circle or a sphere like a ball. So STEM in our lives. So I don't know if you've heard, but this week is very, very important and very exciting for us here at Empire School and Family. So many of you might already know that our school division, Prairie South, has joined with Holy Trinity School Division, and they're working on a project for a brand new school, a brand new joint school, which will combine 4 elementary schools up here on South Hill. And this project is still in the works, but they have begun the next phases. And part of that, the phases for this development is the architects need our help. So architects are just like us, little builders, and we build structures, and they build large structures of, on a bigger scale. So this week, I'm gonna be sending out an activity for you guys at home, and I really hope that you guys take advantage of this activity. It will give your little learner a voice, and it connects a lot to our STEM. So keeping that science and technology and engineering and mathematics in mind, being creative and innovative, right? So really take that opportunity to, if you want a voice in this project, to try it out and fill out the activity that I'll send you guys on Class Dojo today. And please know that it's due Thursday, May 21st. So I'd really like it handed in then, and then I can pass it along to the people that need to be passed on to. So also parents, there will be a video, and I've said this on Class Dojo before, there'll be a video that'll be sent out tomorrow and a survey, and this is an excellent opportunity. It'll highlight everything that's going to happen in this Moose Jaw combined school project, and I just want you to take advantage of it so that you know this school is going to be the future for your students. And so it'll be the place where your pre-Ks, you know, grow from kindergarten or like their next grades on to grade 8K. So I just really want you to take that opportunity. I want to say a big thanks to all of you guys watching at home today. I hope that you guys are able to build some of your structures from home, and please send me some pictures. I'd love to see all the different structures that you guys make. Also, keep checking in on Class Dojo this week. You're going to get more videos on STEM activities that you guys can do straight from your house. Easy materials, just like this. So keep that little innovator alive and those inventors. So I can't wait to see what you guys make. Okay, take care, and I'll catch you guys next How Tuesday. Bye.